Are you pro-fluoride or anti-fluoride? Watch this video as I break down everything you need to know about fluoride in dentistry. Hi, I'm Dr. Violet, your dentist online, and on this channel, I share videos on dental health to help you understand your mouth better. The debate on fluoride has been around for a long time. People have been fighting about whether we should use fluoride in dentistry, especially in drinking water and our toothpaste. But before going there, let's first understand what is fluoride anyway. Fluoride is a naturally occurring mineral that is released from rocks and can be found in soil, water, and air. Almost all the water in this world contains some amount of fluoride. However, the concentration of natural fluoride can differ from one region to another. So in the early 20th century, Dr. Frederick McKay noticed brown stains on tooth enamel in people living in certain parts of the US. He described it as molted enamel, but he didn't know what caused it. Then, in 1931, it was discovered that water in some parts of the US had higher fluoride content and was the reason behind this enamel condition. After the discovery, dental public health scientist Dr. Dean found that these enamel spots caused by fluoride, which he termed as dental fluorosis, correlated with significantly lesser dental cavities in the population. He then did a whole series of systematic research and concluded that fluoride in suitable concentrations can greatly and effectively prevent tooth decay. This became a groundbreaking discovery that led to the proposal for a new public health practice, the fluoridation of drinking water. Consequently, caries prevalence in the US successfully decreased, and many other research on fluoride followed. It was considered by the CDC to be one of the 10 great public health achievements of the 20th century. So, after many decades of continuous studies and research, today fluoride is widely used in dentistry in various forms, either systemic or topical. Systemic fluoride includes water fluoridation, fluoride pills, milk, salt, etc., whereas topical fluoride comes in the form of toothpaste, mouth rinse, gels, varnish, and so on. Recent years, it is shown that the topical use of fluoride directly on the tooth surface has the maximum anti-caries benefit. Systemic use of fluoride, once thought to be the main method of delivery, is now understood to only give a small effect as compared to topical means. However, for populations with high caries risk, systemic fluoride may still be necessary. Fluoride works by stopping or even reversing the tooth decay process. Whenever tooth decay happens, fluoride helps to remineralize the tooth surface by combining with calcium and phosphate to form a mineral called fluoroapatite. This mineral gets incorporated into enamel and is highly resistant to breakdown. Health benefits of fluoride are mainly in terms of strengthening teeth for caries prevention, which in turn prevents a lot of other things associated with tooth decay, like the need for fillings, tooth extractions, pain, and suffering. This table shows the effectiveness of fluoride in reducing caries on the different surfaces of teeth. On a national level, water fluoridation is the single most cost-effective way to control dental caries nationwide, especially in underdeveloped or developing countries. Despite proven evidence, a lot of people are still concerned and skeptical about the safety of fluoride in dentistry. This is because ingestion of fluoride way more than the recommended limit can lead to toxicity and adverse effects. There are also many conspiracy theories claiming all sorts of myths and dangers about it. But in general, their claims about fluoride toxicity are unsubstantiated because they fail to mention the dose. Literally anything, any food, any medication, or even plain water, when consumed in excess, can be toxic to the human body. FYI, did you know that we could actually die from drinking too much plain water? In that case, should we also claim that water is toxic? Based on research, the probable toxic dose for fluoride was defined at 5 mg per kg of body mass. While it is possible to experience toxicity from consuming too much fluoride, it is rare. You have to eat a few tubes of fluoride toothpaste in a short period of time for that to happen. We have to understand that the dose makes the poison. So, is fluoride safe? The answer is yes, if it's within recommended levels. And is fluoride dangerous? Also yes, if above recommended levels. In my opinion, the only valid concern we should have about fluoride is the risk of dental fluorosis. It is an enamel discoloration that can happen when children ingest excessive amounts of fluoride toothpaste during phases of tooth formation. Note that it is caused by fluoride ingestion and not by direct fluoride contact on the tooth surface, which means it is unlikely to happen if a child is able to spit out the toothpaste after brushing. This is why we always educate parents to supervise their child during tooth brushing to ensure that they are doing correctly. But even if you end up with dental fluorosis, it is mostly mild and just an aesthetic concern. A simple procedure at the dentist will give you back your pearly whites in no time. While it's possible for someone to be allergic to fluoride, it is incredibly rare and usually not the case. Toothpaste are formulated with many different ingredients, and some common ingredients that people may be sensitive to are SLS and flavoring. SLS is a surfactant which helps your toothpaste to foam up and give you that squeaky clean feeling when you're brushing. Flavoring just helps with the smell and taste. So if you think you're sensitive to your toothpaste, don't skip the fluoride just yet. You may want to first try out a flavoring-free or SLS-free toothpaste. While many internet articles label fluoride as unsafe, the science speaks for itself. In a generation where we are more prone to come across false news, it's our social responsibility to have the wisdom to filter every piece of information given to us. Health organizations all around the world conduct peer reviews to obtain the highest level of trusted evidence in order to make informed decisions for our better health. They update and publish their guidelines regularly, and the last time I checked, the consensus regarding fluoride still remains. Fluoride is effective and beneficial in oral health prevention. Usage of topical fluoride daily is recommended. So until we make another new groundbreaking discovery on fluoride alternatives, fluoride is still here to stay. If you found this video interesting, do slam that subscribe button and check out my channel for other videos regarding oral health. Until next time, bye!